Nowhere in this book does it say you will live a life without trials. Nowhere in this book does it say you will not be one day persecuted for your faith, that you will not face opposition or loneliness or struggle or pain. It is coming, because right after that spiritual high, right after you've had an amazing day, an amazing season, you walk home to pick up the phone and it's the doctor's report that you never saw coming. That bill you thought that you could pay, you can't pay. The job that you thought was yours, that dream job, has fallen through. You've lost your career, you've lost your family, that house that you wanted, that home that you wanted, that's gone and it's not coming back. And all those dreams and the place that you believed God was calling you, now you're left with nothing but a season and a moment of fear. And this fear is real and it's gripping and it's painful. And what matters in that moment when those trials come, because they will, is how will you respond? Because faith that is not strengthened in the struggle will not last, will not be sustained in success. It'd be a perfect world, wouldn't it? If we could always live in success. Everything we touched turned to gold. Life was always good. No pain, no shame, no guilt, no struggle, no opposition, anything. But that would be a very weak faith. Name anything in life that isn't strengthened when there's opposition. Resistance training is what makes you stronger and stronger and stronger. A few weeks ago, I woke up around 2 or 3 in the morning and I couldn't breathe. I couldn't breathe. I was struggling to catch a breath. And my mind started going through, is this COVID? Is this this? What is this? What is this? And quickly I realized it's a physical symptom of a deeper anxiety that's inside of me. I couldn't breathe. And I'm a professional Christian. I'm not supposed to tell you stuff like this. I'm a paid Christian. I'm not supposed to tell you that I struggled, that at times I wake up in the middle of the night and I can't breathe, struggling to catch a breath. And I have to get up and I have to leave our room and I have to get up and sometimes go outside. And the fear begins to set in that God is not with me in this, that I can't control anything in front of me. Welcome to 2020, the year of fear and anxiety. And yet, Jesus moves towards us. He moves towards you. He moves towards the disciples because he wants them to recognize him, invite him to be anchored in him. So he says, take courage, it is I, do not be afraid, because Jesus is inviting them to see that faith is trusting in God's ability over my limitations. Jesus is saying, take confidence because I am here. So when you're faced with an insurmountable trial, when the darkness has closed in, when your soul is being wrecked, he's telling you, my spirit is at work within you. And when you feel like you've done more than you've ever done and more is coming against you, he says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper, for my grace is sufficient for you. My mercy is new every morning. He says, I am giving you, in the midst of fear and anxiety, I'm giving you the mind of Christ to be renewed and restored and redeemed. All of my promises are moving towards you. And Jesus himself says, in this world, you will have trouble, but take heart, I am has overcome the world.